So they are trying to force the system of Allah to make something what is haram, and they are trying to make it, forcing the system to make it halal, which is not allowed, which is haram, and that will stay haram. Even they make it halala, that is not halal. Even they force the system to make it halal. Now, point to be noted, if they use the system and they force the system to make it halal, that does not become a halal, it is haram. Now, let's go back a little bit. For an example, it all starts when husband issues the three talaq in one sitting. Now, this is the point. When in some sects of Islam, mostly in the Hanafi madhab, all the scholars, they accept three talaq as a three talaq in one sitting if a husband issues the three talaq to a wife. Now, according to the Hanafi scholars, this becomes haram. The woman becomes haram for her husband. And now the husband and wife, the next morning or after a little while, their anger goes down and they want to go back. And now they realize they have issued the three talaq. They go to the scholar and they ask the scholar, the mufti or the sheikh or the local imam and the local council of the Hanafi mazhab. They will say that, okay, you have been now separated because they do have become a mughawar mahram, and this relation is no longer exist because you have issued the three talaq, and that's what the Quran says, talaq marratan. Because according to the Hanafi mazhab, the interpretation of the talaq marratan means if you say it two times, and if you say it third time, that the relationship will be finished, and then she is being separated and she has to go to and she has to do alala. But in some of the, then now there's a different subsect in the Hanafi mazhab. So one of them that belongs to Darul Uloom Dioband, and the other sect which is called Bareilly. In the Bareilly ulamas, they force this system to make this halal, but I haven't seen cases into Hanafi Dioband scholars. They do not do that, but it happens mostly that the cases have been seen. It happens in Bareilly sect of an Islam. What happens when they issue the three talaq? According to their scholars, the relationship has been ended and they have to do a halala, which is like forcing a system of Allah to make the relationship halal. So when the husband and wife go to the scholar, and the scholar say, okay, now you have to do a halala in order for you to go back to your husband. Now, point to be noted, first of all, let's go a little bit back. In the Quran, the talaq does not happen because Allah has not made this relation to just shoot it and it's over and you go back to, you go to a new person and you have a sex with a new person and then you go back. Then he will be issued a talaq, and then you go back to the same husband. Now, this is the process they call this halala. Now, what is halala? First of all, the word halala does not exist. First of all, if someone issues a three talaq at one time, it does not count. That even it is counted as one, and even though it is counted as one, still we have to analyze the whole situation and everything in order to give the ruling if even the one has been affected or not. Now, if the husband issues the one talaq and there's in the period of 3 months, that the Quran says there's 3 months of the period and she has to wait, and within the 3 months, now think about this, why Allah has given the 3 months period of time? So they will be able to get a chance to think more. And for an example, if they do not get along in 3 months and the things are too much conflict between them, then the husband issues the second talaq. Then when the husband issues the second talaq, then Allah says you have another final chance to think for another 3 months. You want to get along with your husband or you want to get a separate. Now Allah has given a chance that you have a chance to think before you make a decision. It's not that you get angry and you make a final decision and everything is finished. Now she needs to get a halala. Now, think about this. There's not even thousands and millions of families are being destroyed only because of the type of the scholars, and these are shayateen in the form of scholars who issues, who gives the process of halala to go get married to another person, and he's going to give you talaq. And what happens that rather going to all that, Allah has given the option, rather than starting a new chapter of your life, rather you stick into the same book, rather than starting a new book, rather go stick into the same book, because the book has not been completed. When you finish the a few pages, like giving a one talaq, you finish the little book and the second book and the third book. When the third talaq is done, then the book is closed. But you have the chance of, you finish the quarter of the book, then you finish the half of the book, and then you have the final stage of the book. If in the final stage, if does not, the thing does not work out, then the husband issues the third talaq, and that becomes irrevocable divorce. Then she is allowed to free, she can do whatever she wants. But in Quran it says a woman has a chance for 3 months, and also it's not only for the woman, and also for the husband, and they both have the chances to think, then make a final decision. But according to these scholars, if you issue the three talaq into the one time, everything is finished, and now you have to go to halala. Now think about this, the talaq is not being happened. The woman has the family, the husband and wife has the children, and they grown up with children, and because of these scholars, now they are being so much disturbed of their mentally and thinking in their heart that the relationship is no longer halal. Now think about this. This is so natural for human beings. Some men has a short temper, some woman has a short temper. When they get angry, after a few minutes they get calmed down, and they will say, okay, I regret that I did that. Now this type of the scholar, they will say this becomes haram. But according to the book of Allah, Allah said you have the chance, it's okay, you can take more and think more. But what is the root cause of destruction of a family? It's an anger, it's a husband's anger, and the second is a woman abusive tongue. If these two things be controlled, and that house is like a peaceful, like a paradise, and there will be never any conflict between them. And the first thing is the woman has to control her tongue, and the husband has to control his anger. Learn to control anger by reciting A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitanir Rajeem. A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitanir Rajeem. This will help you to calm down and do a lot of zikr. And the, what happens, like some husbands has a short temper and some woman has a short temper, and they get a conflict and they get into the fight, and the husband issues the three talaq. But by natural, the human being has a nature, after a little time he would calm down and he would say, okay, I issued your three talaq, and they go to the scholar, say, okay, your talaq is being happened, now you're no longer halal. Now come to the second. First of all, the talaq is not happened. The shaitan in the form of a human being, they start a new book by telling them, okay, you have to go get married. Now let me clarify something. Making a plan to get married with an intention to get a divorce and with an intention to come back to the husband, that's an adultery, that is zina, because this marriage is invalid. That because the word halala and the concept of halala does not even exist in Islam. Because what happened, the husband and wife, it does not get along, and he issues the talaq. Let's say the three talaq is over, and that woman by natural, not with an intention, by natural she wants to start a new life, and she is married now. She's married, she started a new life, and she has a new children, and she does not have any concern with any point in the heart that she married just because she wants to consume the marriage a little bit, and she's going to get a divorce and go back to the husband. This intention is an adultery, this is a zina, this marriage is an invalid, it's not allowed in Islam. This is basically like astaghfirullah, people are fooling Allah, astaghfirullah. They are trying to fool the system. They are trying to force the system to make this halal, because making intention to do something, because the in the Sahih Bukhari, the first hadith is innamal amalu bin niyyah. So she is making her amal as an adulterer, because having a concern she's gonna get married and she's gonna get divorced, she's gonna consume marriage, she's gonna have a sex there, and she's gonna have a marriage, children there or not, but she's gonna get divorced from there and she's gonna go back to the husband. And the person, this is what the Prophet said, who helps in doing all this process, and the one who does that, and the one she married to, all the people involved in this matter of making the system force, that it is curse of Allah on them. They will go to Jahannam because they're making a woman. It's so terrible for me to say that. This is so terrible that the Muslim woman is honored and she is respected. She was respected. Why these scholars are being making a mockery of the woman? They have to think about, this is our daughters, this is our wife, this is our sisters, our mothers, our sisters and our mothers, and we are making a use them, we are making an adulterer by sending them to other women. And shame on these scholars who are playing the whole game to make the system halal. The talaq does not happen, the wife and husband to stay there until they completed the whole process of a one talaq and the iddah time and the second talaq and the iddah time and the third talaq, then the relationship is finished. Then she has a chance to start a new life with a new husband, with the starting with an intentions of a natural marriage. Any marriage that has an intention of going back to the same husband, that is not, that marriage is not valid. It's invalid marriage, and this is not a marriage. This is a haram, and this is zina. This is adultery. It's not permissible. So this is the whole concept of the halal that these scholars has created the whole story, and they made their own religion how to make this halal. It does not exist. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Curse be upon them who involved in this matter by getting married to someone they know, and also the one someone who signed it, and the entire system, whoever is involved into the entire system, that the woman should be going back to the same husband. It's all because be upon them."